This video is for you if you have fear of abandonment, or if you know somebody who does in their relationships and seek reassurance quite often and a lot from their partners. And also for anyone who may experience fear of loss of a loved one or abandonment in any shape or form in the future. So tag along and let's talk about this. For a moment, I want you to imagine that you are your partner, your romantic partner. The other person gets triggered and they reach out saying, "I'm scared of losing you. I can't afford to lose this relationship." It's fine, right? You can take care of them and reassure them that everything is fine. Now, imagine your partner comes up to you and this time they say, quote unquote, "I want to hear you say it. Say that you will never, ever leave me." Now, come back to yourself. You're the person with the fear of abandonment now. Imagine being at the receiving end of this sentence. How do you feel? How does it feel like to you? Perhaps because you also have the fear, so you resonate with it. Perhaps you feel resistance because the person is working as a mirror to reflect your own trauma. Or you may even experience an ego boost because it satisfies your fear of abandonment to hear that your partner is afraid of losing you as well. Quote unquote, "If they're afraid of losing me, that means they're so dependent on me and this helps me to relax my own fear of abandonment. I got this person for myself forever because they themselves are insecure." The truth is that no one can guarantee that any relationship will last for a long time. It is possible, but there are no guarantees. There is one fact of life, however, is that all relationships will have to end because all humans die. At some point, everything has a beginning and an end. Now imagine your partner is triggered and they want to hear it from you. Knowing this truth, you think to yourself, quote unquote, "Well, if I tell them that I will never leave them, I would be lying because I don't know what will happen in the future. I might get hit by a bus, I might leave overseas for work at some point, might grow apart for some reason." As you can see, this is the truth, but if you tell the truth to someone who got fear of abandonment, they will get triggered even more. Now become you again, get back to yourself. You are the one who's getting triggered with the fear, you're back to yourself, but you retain all these new realizations you had from when you were in your partner's perspective, when you were on the receiving end. If you had done this imagination exercise correctly, you should be able to feel the weight that you place on your partners or others in general by seeking this kind of reassurance. I'm not claiming that seeking reassurance is bad or totally insecure. It might be okay at times. Here, we're not demonizing or looking down upon anybody for that matter. We're just engaging in a metacognitive analysis to extract valuable psychological truths about your fear of abandonment that will bring about change and perspective. When you're asking, "Tell me that you will never leave me, ever, ever leave me," what you're basically asking of your partner is to help you feel certain about the future, about life. You want them to stick with you forever, even if you turn out to be a shitty person yourself, right? Notice also the selfishness in your fear of abandonment. You're not really asking them to stay with you forever if we get down to the bottom of it. What you're truly asking is, quote unquote, "I want you to stay with me as long as I selfishly desire." But what if you yourself got bored or you want to be single again? What then? You may argue, quote unquote, No, I'm so insecure, I would love for someone to stay with me forever, actually. I will never change my mind about them, I just want stability." But that is actually bullshit, in most cases. There is many people with fear of abandonment who themselves eventually end up leaving the same partner they were always seeking reassurance from throughout the whole relationship. Notice the selfishness in the fear. Now, this is not always true. many people with fear of abandonment, they really want stability, they want things to last forever, yes, and even people who don't have this fear of abandonment, but there is a big number of people in which this fear is coming from selfishness. The partner might tell them, I stay with you forever, but then when they change their minds, they just leave. And they don't care if the partner wants them to stay. So as you can see, you cannot really... It's quite a selfish fear in some cases. So it's not really about them staying with you forever. It's about them staying with you as long as you wish for them to stay with you. And if you yourself want to leave, you will. And you won't really bother much if they wanted you to stay. It's complicated, as you can see, what you're asking for. And so it's better to express the fear of abandonment in a more realistic way for your partner to help you. For example, instead of asking, tell me you will never leave me, you can phrase it as, I really appreciate this relationship and I'm scared of losing you. It's much easier for your partner to help you soothe the fear in the moment this way. A more advanced way to do this is to express the origin of the fear to your partner. The source of the fear is love. You appreciate the person quite a lot and you want them to be with you. You like being with them. So why not just try to express appreciation to them instead of asking for reassurance all the time? Asking for reassurance is okay, as I said, it's not a problem, but always, always, always that's the problem. Then see how that makes a difference. Every time you feel fear of abandonment, tell your partner that you love them and you appreciate their presence in your life. Or you could simply just talk to them normally. Tell them a joke. Just make contact. This is very difficult to accomplish for people with fear of abandonment, but it's a good try. Releasing the fear by yourself. Another way to help with this fear is to release it by yourself. Instead of asking for reassurance, simply try to contain the fear and keep it to yourself. Bring your attention to the present moment and meditate on the fact that the future is uncertain by nature, and that's okay, but that in this present moment right now, your partner is still here with you. Notice that. Meditate on appreciation and acceptance of an uncertain future. Contain the fear and redirect it to self-love. Ask yourself, quote-unquote, if I were to take all this energy of fear and put it into self-love, into loving myself more and caring for myself more, whether my partner stays or leaves, what would I do for myself today, right now, to increase my own love for myself and progress in my life? And just do the next best thing for you after you ask this question. It could be cooking a healthy meal, exercise, do something that you love. If your partner leaves, deal with it in the moment. Accept the fact that you're capable of dealing with it in the moment. Let it come to you. Until then, enjoy this moment and release all preoccupation with the future. People with fear of abandonment usually experience the possibility, but not even a present reality of separation, as if it was already happening right here, right now. Sometimes all it takes is to look around you and realize that right now there is no separation happening in the present moment. Your partner is still here and there is nothing to worry about. You're almost as if you are experiencing something that might happen in the future, which is not happening now, but you are experiencing it right now in your mind. Let go of it. Remember that fear of abandonment is characteristic of preoccupied attachment style. I have done 2 or 3 videos about preoccupied attachment style. You could check that out. Fear of abandonment can also be characteristic of, to some small extent, avoidant attachment style. So if you have any kind of disorganized, preoccupied, avoidant attachment style, check out my previous videos on attachment styles. There's introduction to attachment styles. If you would like to accelerate the process, guys, check out in the description below my Peak Transformation membership. In this membership, I offer shamanic energy healing and shadow work healing techniques that are very advanced, and they will help you accelerate the fixing of your attachment triggers, as well as any other stubborn emotional blockages you're experiencing right now. Low self-esteem, depression, anxiety, in business, dating, personal or family life. I will be adding in very soon a course about sexual energy mastery. So that would be semen retention, having sex without ejaculation, etc. If you're interested in nofap semen retention. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Comment, leave a like, check out my Patreon page in the description below, and stay tuned next weekend for our next video.